Hello, everybody. We wanted to make a video before we recorded our podcast because I am going to share a story. This is Maria's first time hearing it. So, this will be exciting. This story I'm going to share happened this morning. Today is the 18th of April, and it was very intense, so take this story with pieces, increments, because it really depends on how much you believe in multidimensional realities. So, was intense. Are you ready, Maria?
Was intense. I
Are you
am
ready?
ready. I'm ready.
Right. And it's interesting that this happened this morning because today we're recording about the solar plexus, and as I was going through the day processing what had happened, I was like, oh my God, it was all about my solar plexus. It was all about getting my power back. And like, I'm having epiphanies as I'm even about to talk about it. So I couldn't fall asleep last night. I probably fell asleep around like 4:20 in the morning, and around like 6:40 I realized I was like laying there with one eye open. I was like this. And was like, why is one eye open? Like, this is so weird. But I was so comfortable, and I had all the pillows around me, which never happens. And I was like, all right, spirit, like, should I get up? What's kind of going on? Can you shut my eye? And when I would shut it would just pop back open. Like, I was like, Popeye. It was weird. And all of a sudden, I feel like it was like lucid dreaming where I was awake, but I was not, right? Like, I don't even know how to explain that. Astral traveling while lucid dreaming. And I'm laying in bed. Lily's there. Thank God she ground was grounding me. But all of a sudden I'm in another reality where I look the same. And you and I talked about this. And I was like, is this the earth that we live on now, or is this another earth where I look the same? Because I was trying to understand it. And they were, I was, it was another, it was earth, but a lower dimension me. So I looked exactly like I do. I was doing this business with you, but I looked frail. I looked sick. I looked overworked. I definitely was running on pure adrenaline and all of that. And I remember just like looking at myself, like, what is happening to me? And I'm in Braintree, Massachusetts, but I'm not in Braintree, Massachusetts. It was like this curve, and it looked like a bulb, like it, the Braintree like churned, like it morphed. So, and I've literally been at this place before in my other dreams. And I'm like, what is happening? And I'm like, hi. I'm like waving at myself, and I'm not acknowledging me. And I'm on the phone with Kevin. I'm like, oh, I'm with Kevin in this life. That's cool. Not really. Kevin was cheating on me. And in that reality, I was going to a fair. Me and you were going to go do a fair together. And Kevin was going to come and run the table. And he called and sounded weird. And then we were going back and forth, and I don't remember how it happened, but then he shows up at this, I don't know where I am. I'm like outside packing the car, which is something he would do. And he told me he was not communicating, let's just say that. And then he ended up telling me, and he looked very drained. Like, I looked just as drained, and he looked very drained. And he was telling me he is getting back with next girlfriend. Girlfriend I've never heard of. But I saw what she looked like. And it was his ex-wife on this dimension. And I was like, this is fucked up. So I'm watching it, and I'm like, what is happening here? But she was happier on that dimension versus on this dimension. So it was like opposites. And then me and him started arguing. My heart was literally like breaking. I remember watching myself, and I'm having this conflict with him and I'm just trying to understand. And the whole message was around lack of communication. It was around infidelity and not trusting, like mistrust. Like the whole energy was mistrust. And it was around, I wrote the word down because it was a very specific word. I'll come back to it. But it was really around like, I felt that I shouldn't have been with him, but I stayed with him for whatever reason in that life. And I wasn't listening to myself. And then he was telling me, this is why we don't have sex, because I've been having sex with her. I was like, what the fuck is happening? Yeah. And I'm like, what? And spirit had me and him are bickering. And I'm laying in my bed, but I'm there watching this. And I can feel my heart chakra like breaking. And my arms just started going up. I was sleeping in bed like you do. But I was more like this. And I was like, it was like I was holding something and then like coming to like put like a big hug over me. And I just, while I'm laying in bed, I started like saying, I'm calling in my guides. I'm calling in angels. I'm calling in all this light. And he leaves. He like moves, like his body just moves away. And I literally like died. Like I like dropped and I collapsed and I was dying. I was like, oh my God, I'm actually physically dying because of like the trauma. Like I disassociated that I was dying. And I didn't realize at the time, in spirits, like this is when you have to go over and hug yourself and retrieve your power back, the little power you have left on that dimension. I'm like, what? So I went over and I was hugging me, like we were talking about earlier, like a bear hug. And I went behind and I was hugging me, and all of this yellow was coming out of me. And I was like, just, I was dying, but I was crying, but I was dying. And then I saw Merlin and my soul retrieval guides come in, and then I see this raft, and they're like, you have to retrieve all of these people. You're going to help all of these people raise their vibration to ascend onto the timeline you're in, that you're now coming to this timeline to help them. Like that, what? And so as I'm wrapping myself, I'm heartbroken, but I'm sending Kevin love. I'm sending him in that relationship love. And then I see him get in an accident with them and die. Like with that girl, that lady, whoever he was dating, die. I was like, what the? And so I had to send love healing to that, him. So me and him both died in that dimension. And then I started seeing my mom, all of these people's faces, every single person that I have interacted with on this reality with you and I was on that one my entire life. And their faces were going up in these bubbles of blue, purple, pink, green. And I was laying in bed with my arms like this, crying. Like I was just with one eye open, just crying. Like I couldn't, my body, I had no control over my body. And it was very weird. And like I tried moving my hands. I wanted to wake up, but I was like, I couldn't. And I was putting all of them in these bubbles. And the different bubbles were the chakras where they were feeling like defeated, powerlessness, like fear. It was just like that's the bubbles they were going in. So they can heal that on this reality. Do you follow that? Mm-hmm. Okay. So I was like, so I'm putting them on this raft and then I go to send them out and I hear the door outside. I'm like, oh my God, is Kevin here? Like he can't come in and see me like this. I'm in the middle of like some deep fucking healing. Like what's happening? I was like, spirit, what time is it? And I heard, don't, just keep going. I'm like, okay. And so then I'm seeing all of these guides come in. We're putting them on the raft and I see them float up and I just say, okay, well bring the healing, whatever the heck's happening here, to all of these people when it's in their highest and best on the reality with me. But right now, can you really just do some healing on my heart chakra? So then I picked up dead me, put light around me, and pulled me into my heart. And I'm laying on my bed, and all of a sudden I just like, and I'm crying in my bed, holding me. And I then see, what was happening? Oh, my boobs, like my boobs and my sacral chakra and my solar plexus were on fire. I was like turning. I thought I was going to throw up, but I was lying flat. So that would have sucked. And I'm like, what's going on? But it was like all of my illness in that reality, lower me, was like integrating with me. Do you know what I mean? And when Kevin had told me, when I saw him get in the accident, and then when he had told me about the other woman, I remember my sacral chakra, like it was on fire. I thought I was peeing myself. Like I thought, but I couldn't move. Thank God I didn't piss myself, but you know. So then while we're sending them off on the raft, I see all of the bubbles go up into the sky, and I am seeing them in my reality now. Both of my eyes are open, but I'm asleep, I think. And I'm seeing these bubbles drop down all over, like everywhere, all over the United States. I'm seeing them drop into like there was friends coming up that I haven't talked to since I was like eight, like kids that I grew up with, like this girl, Christy Frazier, that was my best friend when I was young. Like all of these people I haven't thought about for years, their faces are coming in, dropping in. And I'm like, what is happening? So then I asked the guides to come in and just send healing on me. So when Kevin comes home in this reality, I don't freak out and think that he is cheating on me, right? Because I'm like, I have a lot of anger in my body, but I'm really sad. So my hands go back up. And now I realize my head's being turned this way. And I'm being brought to another reality where it is my boyfriend, my ex-boyfriend that I had for 5 years, Brian, who broke up with me on Valentine's Day. And so I was in this reality, right? But I was regressed. And I was like, why am I here? Why? And I'm observing our interactions, and now I'm going through another layer of heartache because it's like the same shit that just happened with Kevin on this other dimension. And me and him are having conversations because when he broke up with me, he moved in with his ex-girlfriend a week later. I don't know if he cheated on me, but I mean, we can connect the dots there. What happened, right? And it was very toxic relationship, but I didn't know it at the time. But spirit said, when I said, why am I being shown this now after I just witnessed me die over here? They're saying that this is where you began to understand the difference between sex and love, but you weren't cognizant of it. Like you weren't conscious to it. I was like, what do you mean? And it was because me and him, towards the end of our relationship, I was in nursing school and I was super stressed. And he worked overnights and I worked three jobs and nursing school. And the last thing on my mind was sex. Let's just say that for the last 3 months. And he also made me feel not pretty because he would judge me a lot when it came to if I worked out, if I didn't work out as much as like the girl over there was working out. So I didn't realize I had all this trauma that I hadn't healed. Whew. And hence why I went to kickboxing tonight and I had so much energy. But they showed me that you thought that was love, but that was toxic love. You thought that was love. And all of the other relationships that you had, you also thought was love. Now you're in love, and that's why you really feel your heart breaking. And so I had to bring healing to him, all of the friendships I had with him. And then I was brought I was immediately like in an elevator, dropped down to another dimension where I'm reliving that same experience. And it's Brian, but like he looks a little different. And I look a little, I like red hair. So I'm like, girl, you didn't learn? Like I'm experiencing it again. So I had to bring what I just realized I didn't heal from, drop it down to lower dimension, do some swirly healing shit, bring it up into this reality. And then it came into my body and my body started convulsing. I was like, what the fuck is happening? I'm like, it's 7 a.m. now. Like, and I hear we're not done. I'm like, oh, great. Cause I'm healing timelines basically where I've been in lower states of frequency. And it was all where my power has been, where part of my power is still lying, where I'm realizing as I'm saying this now, if I lose Kevin, I'll feel like a piece of my power is gone. Because I've given it to so many people before. So I had to go and heal myself on these different timelines to bring in the healing into this one, to know like I am this powerhouse without a guy. I know what love is. I know what intimacy is now. I know what health is now. So that was just an epiphany. So then when I go into that lower dimension, I'm healing that one, doing the same thing. I'm putting them on this raft. And then my head is turned this way. There's this long cord and I'm being brought through a flip book of dimensions. Like it looked like earth, different earth, like, but like not earth, like planets, right? Like not earth. And I'm brought to Egypt and I'm like, what am I doing here? Like, I don't have to heal that. Like, what am I doing here? And now my hands are like this in bed. And a couple of my clients, which I'm not going to mention on this, were in this Egyptian place with me, this wherever I was. But I was laying on this tomb, and it was me, but not me. Like I was longer. I was something. The man, or this entity, this energy, I don't even know what to call them. And I was observing it, was stabbing into my heart, ripping my chest open and eating my heart. And I was like, what is happening here? And I'm watching it and I'm laying and I'm angry. Like I'm so angry and I'm in bed. And I'm like, and my hands are still like this. Now my legs are twitching. And I'm like, stop it. Like, stop it. Like he's eating my heart, whoever this is. But he was eating it with this energy of like, no one can have her type of thing. So I didn't know who this energy was. It's really fucked up. And then all of a sudden I hear, call on your higher self. So I called on my higher self. I see this like glistening silver purple lady, whatever, coming in through that man or whatever that being was, through them, and take my heart out of their hands and mouth and like put it back into my chest on in this tomb. And all of these guides and my clients we're like sewing me back up, like, and then mummifying me. And they were saying, we have to keep you pure. We have to keep you pure. So whatever that was about. But it was taking a long time. Like it was, cause the next time I looked at my clock.
Oh no, you're fine. Sorry. Go ahead.
There you go. So the next time I looked at my, my clock, so I was able to like turn my head, because I had my phone like this, sitting up next to me. It was a good 45 minutes. I was in Egypt. And you know time is an illusion. So like the fact that it was taking that long wherever I was to do this healing. And mind you, when this is happening and they're sewing me up, I'm actually feeling it in my body. Like I'm feeling my body being jabbed and pulled. And similar to our experience with the Conjuring House. Yeah. This is Egypt. And I'm like, well, this isn't a pleasant morning. And once I was all sewn up and wrapped up with these things, there was this flip book again, now going forward. And I heard healing bloodlines. I'm like, okay. And I was brought to, which I made a video about, the life where I'm lying in the hospital bed with cancer and they're like ripping my chest open. And then I was brought to that other life where I had that addiction, right? And they like came together. So I feel like it was the same life, but they were coming together. And all of my guides were there, but it was my higher self moving through. And I had died in that life too, that dimension. And my whole chest, like my breasts were gone. Hence why I have the sore. And then my lady parts were removed from that life. And I just had to go over and hug me and tell my soul, because I was like kind of stuck in my body or something. Like I was stuck there. And I had to tell myself, it's okay. It's time to be reborn. And I was just crying again in my bed. And I'm asking spirit, can you hurry this up? Because like, this is not how I want to start my day. But it's happening for a reason, because it's the intentions I set. And I'm over myself hugging me. And as I am, I just see all of these lives that are on lower vibrations coming up, like multiple ones and ancestors, and like coming up, like clapping together and going into me, where my whole body, Maria, when I tell you, like, you know when you have a heating pad on your belly,
yep,
or your back, and it's hot, and you're like, fuck, it's still on, it's burning me. My whole body, from left to right, slowly became like that. And I was like, and then right to left, and then top to bottom, and bottom to top. And I was like, what the fuck? And I was so hot, yet it was like when you have a fever, because I was so cold.
Yep.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, I hate that feeling.
And I heard, now you're becoming whole. And this is where all of your power has been. Now it's time to like release the attachments to thinking that you're not good enough to, you know, feel sexual and loving and sensual in your body. Now it's time to release these attachments to all of the people that you've had loving relationships with, and all of this anger towards whatever that bloodline was. And it was all my heart, solar plexus, and lower chakras. And then I heard, it's going to fuck up some people, not fuck it up, but it's going to trigger people moving forward because of all of the healing that was just brought through, like all of the people I've encountered. And I'm like, oh, great. I had, I kid you not, 7 people text me, like before I texted you, 7 people text me and say, so you just came flashing into my vision and I have this very uneasy feeling. What's going on? I'm like, oh, it's okay. It's just healing happening. You were just ready to receive it. Just allow it. And then I hear the doors shut outside. I'm like, all right, spirit. Now my hands are like back like this. And I'm like, all right, spirit, let me be normal. I'm still like this. And I hear, he's really going to feel it, because I also set intentions for all addictions, all addictive behaviors, anything that is coming from lack to also be released. And you know what I mean with all of that, Maria, around relationships and stuff. And I was like, why did I just ask for that? But it was like I had no control over it. Do you know what I mean? Like, it was like someone else was setting the intentions. Does that make sense?
Your higher selves, perhaps.
Probably.
Yeah, because I feel we should preface, like, you didn't heal anyone without their permission. I feel Correct. Like you need to say that right now.
Oh,
just
yeah.
Saying. Okay.
Oh, yeah. Oh, so, like, healing, I mean, like, shifting energy. I don't mean, like, whoo, you're all healed. It's, like, bringing awareness and bringing compassion. And that was the other thing that was, it was, the big word was forgiveness. And bringing forgiveness to things that I've been attached to that have maybe affected others, but also bringing this energy of awareness and compassion to others that they've been affected by very consciously or unconsciously. And it's just like spirit had me bring these bubbles of light through them and through their chakras and then put them on this like raft. So they all would come up and ascend together. Like they would start to, it was almost like their healing was now beginning to begin. Like a new level of awakening was beginning. So that's what I mean by healing. It's like I just put the key in their engine and now it's like they step on the gas. Like it's like something like that. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Cause spirit was literally like healing me on these lower dimensions, but I had to die first, right? Like I had to see some shit first in order to bring in the awareness that like, wow, I'm on a lower vibration on these lights, but like I have to have compassion for myself because I didn't know better. But now I've been brought to me on those lives to be like, hey guys, let's come on this dimension. We're good. We're all together. And so that's what my higher self was doing with them, the people. Like I wasn't doing it. I was just lying in my bed. Like, you know what I mean? Because we can't heal anybody. We can just give them a drop seeds and push loving energy towards people.
Mm-hmm.
Thanks for that, Maria.
No problem.
Yeah, because I was so confused the entire time, like what was happening when I was seeing me go down like these elevators and then up and then shifting to different like planets. And I was in the sky at some point doing shit. And then I was back down in my bed. And I'm like, this was like 2.5 hours of whatever this was. And I'm just laying there. And then, so I hear Kevin. I'm like, oh God, just pretend you're sleeping. So like, but I'm like so wide awake now. Cause I'm like, I really need to soothe myself and go for a walk in nature or something. Like, so I don't know what to do with myself because I don't know what just happened. And one of my clients texted me and I shared part of the experience, Egyptian thing. And he said, was I there? And I said, yeah, you are. He goes, because when you just shared that you were in Egypt and someone was eating your heart, I had this flash forward, sideways, backwards, whatever. And he was saying that I like healed one of the, or not healed, I sent light, like did ancestral clearing or something. Like I did some type of clearing on this trauma that came from one of the original bloodlines. And I was like, oh, I'm just thinking that because I was watching this video before bed. And spirit was like, this is why you were watching this video before bed, because otherwise you wouldn't have known what the heck was happening in the dream. You had to see what the 13 quote unquote bloodlines were, whatever. I was like, okay, because what was happening is that one of them, because I was pure in that life, whatever, they wanted it or whatever they were trying to do. And it was like, my higher self was like, sorry, it's not happening on this new earth or the earth she's in now. Like, nope. And that's why it flipped book forward to all of these lives where whoever that person was, their ancestors, bloodline from eating my heart, caused trauma and destruction to keep us in these lower realities. Does that make sense? Yeah, so it was like fucking wild. And yeah, when I got up, even though I slept like literally like 2 hours, I had this new renowned sense of like self with intense confusion. But I was like, okay, one, what just happened? Two, I can't wait to tell Maria because she's the only one that's going to really understand this.
Yep.
Three, I think whatever just happened was extremely powerful in the energetic sense of really showing love to everybody who may be still in a lower vibration on this reality or another one that needs a hug, that needs literally what I gave my dying self, right? Like, to know that they're safe. Like, it's okay. Do you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
It was wild. Oh, the last thing. When I was in Egypt, when they were done sewing me up or whatever the heck they were doing, and my scar was burning the whole time. It was like, but they showed me a modality a couple years ago, spirit. And it has to do with this rose and this healing energy modality that I do when I'm doing literally energy work, people energy shifting, whatever. And it's opening the heart chakra two ways. And I have this key in my mind that I pull out and I do this spin wheel and then I do it back and I do it 12 times. And I never understood why. And this morning I did, because that's what they did to sew my quote unquote heart back into place. They sewed it 12 times around and then back. So they released the pain and they balanced it. And I was like, how many petals does the heart chakra have? 12.
Mm-hmm.
I was like, oh, duh, Sam. But they were like, this is why you're here. This is why you and Maria are here. And that's why it started. The whole thing started because me and you were going to do a fair, but I was, and you were too, like, we were just in very low densities. We were still in this mindset of the same one we were in with nursing.
Yep.
And it felt like work. And then we weren't supported. And it was like, and my body literally gave out on me and my heart broke. It was like, because I wasn't in my authenticity. I wasn't in my empowerment. I was in that wounded masculine control and go. And I was neglecting seeing things in my own relationships and like life. Like,
not in your power.
Not in my power.
Yep.
Like, so of course it happened today on the solar plexus day.
Of course. Why wouldn't it?
Yeah. But it was wild because spirit's like, this is part of your identity. Like you are this pure energy and you do have so much to share with the world and humanity, little pieces at a time. And it doesn't have to be where you're physically with someone or someone knows you're doing it. It's you literally just setting the intention. Like, I just send that person compassion.
Mm-hmm.
I forgive that person for cutting me off. Like, it's rather than like this hate and this anger. It's like, I feel like new. Like, I feel reborn. It's weird. Yeah. So I just wanted to share it because I'm going to write it all out in a better way for my book, but it was nuts.
Do you want my perspective on everything that happened? All right.
Yeah.
Yes.
Because I know a lot of it too, but
I've had very similar experiences. And for me, so I'm going to get into like my perspective of being multidimensional. And I believe that there, well, I mean, I've seen all of these versions of me in a sense, like we've talked about, like I've seen other me's and other time eras that are not this avatar, but I've also seen this avatar in many other realities and a lot of the same people, all in your avatars, like in my life, but in different ways, shapes and forms, like not necessarily my business partner, but like you're in my life in another sort of in another role or whatever. So mm-hmm. to me, like what you did in a sense, you did like a very intense soul retrieval in a sense, like, and soul retrieval in the sense of like, you just brought more light into your body here. Like mm-hmm. when I look at it from purely like an energy perspective, like a quantum kind of perspective, it's being awake just really drums down to how much light quotient is in our physical body. And so this is why I believe in other dimensions, we are quote unquote more awake and quote unquote more asleep, because I believe all of us have lower dimensional selves that still exist. And then there's these higher dimensional selves, like in Egypt and, you know, Atlantis and all these other versions of us that are maybe in a different avatar, but it's still our consciousness. And we're just have more of our soul walking around in that physical body. And mm-hmm. So like, I'm listening to you, and it's funny because I started thinking about multidimensional again today after you had texted me that like, whoa, something wild happened. Like, you didn't get into it with me, but it was like, oh, she had one of those experiences like that I've had, where very similar, not exactly playing out the same way, but essentially, yes, being shown these lower versions of me and also the people in my life. But I also know, like, is that, have I created those other versions of them because I'm in a lower state? So it mm-hmm. goes back to when we raise our consciousness in our body. So that's what I feel like those bubbles were, is like you were raising your consciousness in a sense into this reality. You were pulling more of your light into this body. So then it was affecting how you were seeing the other people in your life. Not even necessarily like you were doing anything that, like, yes, you were, but not really like to them. I think that's why mm-hmm. I like interjected, because it was like your those bubbles with the light in it. It's like, it's because you were raising your vibration, your frequency, your energy. So now you were meeting another version of them. And I literally mm-hmm. feel like that's what is happening throughout this whole evolution process, is that mm-hmm. and you and I have talked about it before in other videos about like five-dimensional Earth. Well, five-dimensional Earth is here. Five-dimensional Earth is here. Six-dimensional Earth is here. 12-dimensional, like, they're all here. That's why you and I see mm-hmm. so many Earths.
Yeah.
But it's a matter of getting this illusionary physical body to meet that vibration and to mm-hmm. like, to, but it doesn't mean that some of those other lower vibrational me's still don't exist. I do think some of them do die off. I think that's where you and I have literally, because we've talked about this, like, are we even dying in those other lives, or was that just a potential? Because you and I also know that any thought we create gets dumped into the Akash, and it's energy. It never stops. So that's where it gets wild. It's like, oh, because I had that thought, then there was a reality rooted in that thought that played out, or that is mm-hmm. playing out. And so I feel like the more we tap into all of these dimensions, it's like we're really just pulling our awareness from those bodies into this body, which in turn is helping us to ascend, you know, that word ascend, even that has become like,
yeah, I just think it's like level up. Like,
and to me, it's literally just like, there's just more of our soul, our consciousness in our body and in this body. Anyway, it's like you and I could literally be having the same conversation on 12 other dimensions for all we know. Right. And we're like, mm-hmm. oh, yeah, like that lower dimensional self. And we're talking about these us's, you know, mm-hmm. it's like, that's where it does. It gets batshit crazy when you really start to like understand this multidimensional reality. And I just had somebody text me the other day. And it was almost like, because I have this sort of inner and understanding of it now, I don't always know how to answer people that are asking me about like their loved ones, right? That have died.
I know, right?
Because I'm like they're not just one soul, one person, right? And that's where we're so stuck in this linear, limited matrix mindset, that like we think when our loved one dies, like they have just this like one part of them that like floats up to heaven. And it's like, you know, if people only know our loved ones are like in a lot of different avatars, like,
yep.
And I know that from just me seeing myself in other avatars. Like, I think we talked about it when you were here, mm-hmm. where I was like, you know, I'm starting to have this like weird feeling like there's other parts of my consciousness, like in completely other bodies, but walking in this dimension, almost like what people would say is a twin flame. And even that, I don't even think is like a thing, to be honest.
Me either.
I think it's another sort of label like a soulmate that has been created to, it's like this romantic thing. And it's like, I see beyond that now. Like, I think it has its place in evolution, but it's like, I'm like, that's still such a limited, like, perspective of things. And that's where, when you start to have like a limitless, as we do now, perspective, it gets weird, because it's like,
very weird. Right,
so how do I tell this person, like, and it was somebody that reached out to me about feeling their loved one around them, and that it's making them feel uncomfortable because they feel like, doesn't this person have other things they need to be doing? Like, do you know, and a lot of mm-hmm. people feel that way. Like, why are they hanging out with me? Like, don't they want to be like doing other things? And I literally, like, I had to pause for a second. I was like, Spirit, help me on how to answer this. Cause I want to give her the answer that she's going to understand, that's going to bring a sense of peace,
but and the most healing,
correct,
right?
In the highest and most healing way for her to receive mm-hmm. the information. But I also know I have this awareness now for a reason, to help mm-hmm. people start breaking out of even the linear limited thinking in the spiritual business land genre, whatever you want to call this realm that we're dancing in now. It's like, okay, so how do I say it? So it was like, they were like, you tell her that we're multidimensional, and that while we're here in the human form, we get very attached to that is that person. And we have like, we think like they just have, yes, we only have one soul, but our soul can fragment or split off into multiple different things. That's what's the badass thing about being the creator. Like, that is what the creator did with all of us. That's how we are what we are, because the single creator literally just split into all these different realities. And so if we're an aspect of that, well, we're doing the same thing. So I mm-hmm. explained it to her. I was like, you know, he is with you because he's choosing to be with you. And the more you're keeping his spirit alive or his energy alive, like in your memories and talking about him, of course you're going to feel him around you. It's like you're calling him in a sense, just by thinking about him and having all of these loving feelings, you're literally calling his energy, but his energy is also doing 50 gajillion other things. So don't think you're taking away from his like path in a sense.
Yep.
And she was like, oh my God, that makes so much sense. I'm like, really? Okay, good. Cause usually that wouldn't make sense to people, but thank you, Spirit. For being able to like put it in a way that like she, you know, she's going to receive healing from it and, but also be able to understand the sort of bigger picture. And the bigger picture mm-hmm. is like when, and I feel like this is why you and I have a very different way of doing soul retrieval and psychopomp, because we have this very multidimensional perspective of things. We've been shown it so many times, whether it's through our clients or in our own, like, you know, like what happened to you this morning has happened to me in the bath before, like totally just like not looking to go journey, not trying to do anything, but just kind of like, and here we go.
Yeah, it is your time.
Like, what? And then I had another similar experience to you a couple months ago when I was wicked sick. Remember when I was like sick mm-hmm. and like almost the whole month of December? And I was shown, I feel like I might've told you, but I was shown this other me in this body in a hospital bed, because my body was like hurting like terribly. And I literally was like, I feel like somebody took a bat to my entire body. And me and Allison, who's my other best friend who lives in my backyard, we were sitting outside, and it was wild because we were both like brought to this same vision without even trying to be. And it was me in a hospital bed. Like, I had just been severely beaten by my ex.
Oh, so you felt it before you saw it. Okay, gotcha. Yeah, yes, fucking wild how that works.
Remember, you and I, if we recall what we've talked about before, my sort of, we'll say, main gift is that clairsentience first. So the clairsentience mm-hmm. comes, so the feeling of it, and then the clairvoyance comes, like, right after it. You're, like, the other way. You always saw and then fell mm-hmm. after. And mine's always like a feeling. And then my clairvoyance came online. It was like, okay, now I see what I'm feeling. Okay, this makes sense. So it's like yep. We're yin and yang, opposite. So I'm out and I'm like, but then I'm like seeing myself in this hospital bed and there's Ed in the corner as a cop, right? And he was in there because I had just been domestically abused. So he was standing like watching my room, but he didn't like, we weren't in a relationship or like he was the cop there, but a perfect mm-hmm. example of like all the same players in my life. And Allison was my nurse in that dimension, taking care of me. And I was hooked up to all this stuff. And this was wild because it was so like, it was just like, I'm listening to you today and I'm like, wow. Yeah. Like I, you're right. I do get it. I get it like on so many levels in so many dimensions. Yep.
And on many timelines.
Many timelines. Yeah. It's just wild. But it was like, I saw this version of me that if I had perhaps stayed in an abusive relationship, like I was in before I met my husband, that would have been the path that would have happened for me. Like that would have, mm-hmm. so that there's an example of what I mean about like, here I was in this relationship previously that at the time in my life, you know, I was 17, 18 when I got into that relationship and I was in a shitty emotional space in my life. So what greater time to dive into an abusive relationship? But there was a part of me that thought I would like marry him and I would be with him. So, mm-hmm. and there was a lot of emotion backing that thought. So in some dimension, some reality, that carried out as a reality because I intended for it to, even though this dimensional me chose to walk away from that relationship and it was hard too, but it's like, there was still another me that had dreamed about what my life would be like, you know, had I stayed with him. So I know in the Akashic field, that reality continued to play out. And basically that's what I was shown in that experience. It was like, hey, so here's that reality. And it all had to do very similar, like with yours, it was all a message about worth and worthiness mm-hmm. and where I gave my power away tremendously, where I really like lost myself in a sense when I mm-hmm. was in that that extremely abusive relationship. And even having a knowing when I was in it that it wasn't good for me. Like, I mean, come on, at some point you as brainwashed as you can be in those relationships, there is still a part of you that's like, yeah, I probably shouldn't be in this anymore. Like, this is not a good situation. But it's like, again, it's like your other dimensional yous that we're staying in those, and it's usually out of fear, right? It's, we tend to, even though we can be in a toxic sort of situation, it's what we know. So we'd rather stay in that than step into the unknown. And I feel like these dimensional us's are breaking those patterns and cycles of those lower dimension us's. So we're like pulling them in and we're pulling them into this body. We're pulling that light quotient that's walking around in that reality into this body, which is then just bringing more consciousness and awareness into us, which in turn is affecting everybody around us too. And also how we see them. Cause it's, you know, it's, you and I talk about this all the time. We can't change anybody. I don't think we can even like change this earth. And I feel like there's a reason I heard this little snippet the other day. Crazy. It was two nights ago. I walked into the bedroom and Ed was like watching something on his phone. And it was a guy talking about how basically that none of us actually change this earth. We change us and shift to a higher dimensional earth. Because, correct. And I'm like, and when I heard it, it's like, duh. Yeah, I know that. Like, that's like, this lower dimensional earth is going to play out for as long as people want to play in the lower dimensions. But it's like,
correct.
We're pulling those lower yous up because they don't want to mm-hmm. play in those dimensions anymore. So it's like, now you're pulling it into this one because this is the one that you're most consciously aware of, we'll say. Mm-hmm. So this is the one you're working on. So you're pulling those up into this to help us shift again into that higher frequency of the higher earths that very much already exist. They never went anywhere. Like, I don't believe Atlantis went anywhere in this earth. We're told it's no longer here, but that's because this is a lower dimension than what the frequency of Atlantis. Atlantis is still there. All of these places are still there. But if we're taught that they fell, right? Like, there's this, that they got like in this reality, Earth, they did, because in a lower dimension, that's what happens. War,
yep,
and fear take over. But then mm-hmm. there's still a higher dimension of that place, if that makes sense.
It makes 1,000%. That's why, like, when I, and I feel like you're the same, like, when I'm doing readings with people, if they bring me into other places for, like, other lives of the person, they don't give me exact locations, but they'll be like, this is where Egypt, or this is where Africa is before it was that. Like, they're very, like,
yes,
they don't yes. give me exact locations. I'll say, like, I feel like I'm in England, but I can't, I don't give times anymore, because it's like, I don't know, because I'm, I don't know.
Because we are breaking that illusion of time and space.
Yeah. Yeah. And when you were saying about, you thought you were going to marry that guy, another epiphany, that's what happened with Brian. We were going on this Valentine's Day weekend vacation with his buddies somewhere up north. And everybody told me he had a ring. He's going to ask me to marry him. And then we go on this vacation. He didn't. And then he breaks up with me on Valentine's Day, the night before I had this big maternity exam. It's probably why I hate maternity. I just hated that class in general, but.
Me too.
Ugh.
Here we are. Like, no babies.
Yeah. I'm like, this.
I hated
it. Ugh. Fuck. Me too. I was like, ugh, get me out of this class.
Me too.
Yeah. Wow. It was the only class I didn't do good in nursing school. Just for that.
Yeah, I struggled with it, as that was a challenge. Well,
my own.
Here with our sacral chakras reborn, nope. Maybe we'd look at it differently now.
Maybe. Or maybe not.
Probably not.
You know, depending on who teaches it and what's taught. But so here I am, as you're saying this, I am now engaged to Kevin, who I fully feel safe with, I fully trust, and like who has been super supportive of me shifting my role of power, right, from nursing to this very unknown, beautiful, expansive business that we have. And then here I am with this other guy who I thought I was going to marry, who didn't fully support me, who didn't have his shit together. We were young, though, like, so you can't blame him. But there was also this, he had a very strong lack of self-worth, and he would judge me if I didn't work out how he did, or if I need how he did, like, judge. And mm-hmm. Kevin doesn't judge me. So, yes, it was fear. I was going in healing, but I had to go back to that timeline, which I know was just, like, this life at whatever point, where I was still stuck in that fear of, wow, now I'm in this really safe relationship, though. Like, what if he leaves me to be with an ex, because that's what Brian did, right? And so I also thought of that when I woke up, except the whole marriage thing, but you brought that to my awareness. And then Spirit was like, yes, it is a fear of yours, but what's happening is you on that dimension weren't taking care of yourself. On this dimension, you are. So that's why you're saving yourself on that one.
Exactly.
And you're also saving him on that dimension, because you're showing him compassion, even though he just broke your heart. Right. But like, you know that that's just a potential. And but you know his real him is that pure energy on this one. Like, you know that. And so I was like, oh, okay. So it was like I had to, and they were telling me, like, it's also his fear too, you know? I'm like, oh, wow, that's weird.
That's how cords are created. That's what a cord is.
Yeah, so it was like, I was like.
Exactly. And when you were talking earlier, it was like, oh, she did like a cord cutting ceremony in a sense.
Mm-hmm.
When you were talking about, well, you even said a cord, but I did a cord cutting ceremony like a year ago. And a lot of it was all about how the only cords we should have with people should be coming from our heart chakra, because that's mm-hmm. literally just coming from unconditional love and compassion. All these other cords from all of our other chakras are because there is that same energy in that person. And I'm glad you said that, because I talk about this all the time with clients, like, especially the ones that are still seeking a significant other. And they're like, why haven't I found him yet? Why? Like, and it's like this still, again, creating from lack type of thing. But as you can see, perfect example of you in the lower dimension, same thing with me. I attracted the relationship of abuse because I was abusing myself. I had no worth. So of course I'm attracting somebody who also has no self-worth, because people that abuse is because they have no self-worth. They have no confidence themselves. So that's where we create that solar plexus cord, those sacral chakra cords with people, because we may be we may be expressing it differently, but the energies that we're both carrying or we're all carrying are the same one. So then we're having these cords from chakra to chakra, because it's like, that's why we say when we heal ourselves, that's what shifts people, because we're releasing our fears layer by layer by layer, showing it love, which in turn is having that energetic effect outward to everybody around us. And like what you were saying, it triggers people. Yes, it triggers people, but it's just, you know, it's just their ego that's being triggered by like something they're feeling and they can't explain it. They can't put words to it. So it triggers it. That's the trigger. It's like they're feeling something and they don't know why they're feeling what they're feeling. So it's an energetic trigger, meaning like there's something new that they're becoming aware of that they're feeling in their body. That's a great way of actually explaining a trigger, because we think that triggers are always like this sort of bad thing and like people get angry. And it's like, I know for me, I can be triggered and not get angry. I can just feel a trigger of an emotion in me that's like a jolt of it. And it's like, whoa, okay, like I was just triggered. Like, but it doesn't, it's not always in like a negative, like now I'm pissed or whatever. It's just like, well, there's an energy I was unaware of. So I feel like that's what happened in your experience, is like you brought all the light, you shed light on people and their unconsciousness. So now it's like, they're all of a sudden have an awareness or a trigger or a consciousness pop in and they're like, why, the what, what, huh? Yeah.
Yeah.
Wild.
Wild. And yesterday I was working with a client. When you're saying triggering, I remember, so I was doing like this channeling, this energy work on them. Like I was bringing them in a guided meditation. And at the same time, I'm like doing whatever, cutting cords with them while they're also in it doing it. And what came through was like, know that you are the light, and to know that the light does flicker. And when it flickers, it stays light. So like, I was like, oh my God. Cause when he said that back to me, he's like, yeah, you said I have a lot of light and it flickers. I'm like, oh my God, that's a trigger. That's a trigger. Cause the light flickers cause something triggers, something energetic is just triggering it, whether it be a faulty wiring, whether it be a ghost, whether it be whatever, right? It's the light is just being flickered, it's triggered, but it will always stay up unless you're not, if it is like a light bulb and it dies cause you're not, you know, whatever, but you know what I mean? Like I thought it was a really cool way to say trigger, because it's like, no, you just get flickered. You just flicker. Your light just gets flickered.
Yes, because there's even now all this like stigma like around trigger, you know, like everything. We as humans just rip everything apart and overanalyze and overlabel everything. But yeah, to me, that's exactly all a trigger is. It's like a flip. Like oh, something I was unaware of. That's really what it is. It's like it's an energy, a thought, an emotion, an experience, something that has always been there, because as we know, energy is neither created nor destroyed. It doesn't go anywhere. But when we're in this avatar, we have a very intelligent ego. It is very intelligent. It knows how to push stuff into our non-conscious memory. It pushes it to the side, but it doesn't actually go anywhere. It's just we as the human choose not to remember things. But yeah, it's...
And when we were talking about
crazy.
I had to share that with you.
No, and I'm glad, because it's very resonating with many experiences I've had in the last year. And I think I've had these experiences because I told you at the beginning of 2022, I'm like, I'm going to break the illusion of time. And that has done nothing but, I won't say fuck me up, but it has really been like, oh, wow. Like, the illusion of space and time is an illusion. And that's a really weird, like you hear people say that all the time, but when you really like experience it, it's freaky.
Mm-hmm.
Freaky.
Yeah. And I was like just setting intentions like I always do, like allow me to
release
break free
what no
from
longer serves.
Yeah. Well, I don't use that as much, but I usually like do something more specific. Yeah. But I also have just been asking like before bed, like release any parts of me that are not mine, any energies for me, blah, blah, blah. But I also keep asking like I am ready to release anything that has been taking my power, anything I am not consciously aware of, something I won't tap into, just bring it into me, bring it to me that I know I need to heal from because I can handle it. Like I can do it. And I did that before bed. And I watched that video of the bloodlines because I was also like asking about the angels. I was like, I work with the angels a lot, but I know that they're just a fragment of me. I'm a fragment of them. So like, what's up with the angels? Right? Like I was like thinking and I was like, please bring that into my awareness. Thanks. And it was like when they were the guy, whoever was eating my heart, they were basically like, because you're pure like an angel. So angels are considered pure, but like you're just like them. Like you're right. But it's easier for you to bring in an angel to share with somebody because it's the opposite of like it has this different vibration, a higher frequency on it. But you are becoming that higher frequency. But you need to release these lower frequencies first, like cross all these, right? Like you can't just, you know, just go right up the elevator chute. I mean, wish we could.
Well,
but
there
I was
a part
awesome.
Of us that is. That's
a part
the
of us
irony.
That is there. Yeah. Hence the part of me that silver being that came down and had this like long silver hair. And I know it was just like for me to understand what it was, but it was just like the silver lilac glow. And people have mentioned that that's what my higher self looks like, and like in the shamanic stuff and other things. And so when I started to come in and go to all these people and like to me, and I was like, whoa, because I've experienced this before. These things are like you did in the tub. We know we both do this a lot. So that's why this morning, this one was just so like, whoa, like different. You know what I mean? Cause it was like, and I asked, do we die? Like, do we die? If I die on this reality in another body, do I know? Like, do I know? And well, we do. And if you're ready to know, you will know, because I felt it this morning because I did die a couple times, but I wasn't scared of the death. It was like, oh, I needed to die so I can be reborn. I can be in that higher quotient of light. Like I needed to raise my consciousness, you know?
This is why I do believe too that 100% we choose our death. Like I don't mean in the conscious human way. I mean like people, because you know I was like glued to near-death experiences like last year too. Like I was infatuated with listening to people's mm-hmm. and just all of that. And it validated like all the ones I would listen to validated my like understanding of the Akashic record really. And also the fact that it's all choice. So like when the avatar dies for whatever physical reason it's dying from, there it is the soul that's choosing whether or not the avatar actually dies or not. And
yes.
I really like, yes, it's like because the soul is literally, this is weird too because I just had this conversation I feel like with Allison the other day after something she said, and I had this like epiphany of like, and it ties in with all of this. It's like, all right, so you know, when we disassociate, we talk about like disassociating, leaving the body, right? This is how it came up. We're talking about like leaving the body and why we do that. And we do that because the human feels unsafe. So then the soul, the light, whatever, like basically just go, oh, I'm going to tap into this dimension right now because this reality feels unsafe. So we leave the body, we disassociate. But like what they were showing me is like, yeah. And when you do that, that's why your actual body goes into a fight or flight, because controller of it, basically the one running it, mm-hmm. that's supposed to be operating it, has left in a sense, but the body has been trained and programmed to survive. So what happens is it goes into its natural sort of survival instinct. It's like, all right, well, the consciousness is not controlling me right now. So I'm going to use my intelligence and I'm going to go into fight or flight. And that's why I feel like many of us are in that fight or flight majority of our life when we're disassociating, we're leaving.
You just lost me. Hold on. You just lost me. I was rolling with it, and then I was like, what do you mean my consciousness leaves and I'm in fight or flight? Like, you mean like my spirit, like source energy, like spirit, or like, are we just totally on like ego, or what do you mean?
So I'm talking about like consciousness, which to me is source, is spirit, is soul. It's all the same. To me, it's all my light. It's all like, those are all synonyms for my soul, my spirit, my consciousness.
So what about your subconscious, which is your ego?
That's part of the body, is what I'm saying.
Okay.
I'm talking about my consciousness.
Okay. Gotcha. Okay.
My soul, my spirit, the one that's actually incarnated into the body because it has chosen to come into this body to experience whatever this body's reality is going to be. So
when what you're saying. Okay.
Gotcha. This person starts going through life and does not feel safe anymore, my consciousness, this is what to me they were showing me disassociating actually means, is like it taps into other realities. And this is because Allison and I had these scans done, and it tells you how much you're in theta, beta, all that shit. Like, it tells you, like, it gives you, it's a quantum scan, and it's wild. So this is how we got talking about it, because she found out she's very much in theta a lot, which means she's essentially disassociating. She's tapping into that realm where, right? So then we were trying to figure out, like, all right, so then as we were talking about it, it's like I was getting this download of, like, yes, this is what happens, because equally the fight or flight response is up. And I'm like, that makes sense, because now the body, I'm not talking about the soul in the body, I'm talking about this intelligent vessel, the body itself, gotcha. Which is run by the brain, which is your subconscious, your conscious, like that part of the brain, the physical body, the physical avatar, now goes into survival mode, because the consciousness that is supposed to be in it, basically operating it and running it, has tapped out. It's tapped into another dimension. It's tapped into another reality, because the human has felt unsafe. So now the body goes into fight or flight, meaning it goes into survival mode, because it's programmed and designed to survive. So this is why I think a lot of people that disassociate are also in fight or flight, because your body is now taking over. And when I was like getting this sort of download, I'm like, oh, it makes so much sense, because everything that, like, when I listen to Joe Dispenza, it talks about how, like, your body has its own muscle memory, right? So when we're programmed, by the time we're 35, 95% of us is running off of subconscious programs. The body is now taking over. Like, now the body is telling us what to do, because we're robotic. Like, we're getting up and making a coffee without even realizing that's what we're doing, because it's like become such a program. So now the body is taken over. Why? Because the person, the soul, I'm not going to say the person, the soul in the body has disassociated. So now the body takes over, and it's living in fight or flight, which means it's basically living in unconsciousness. That's essentially what fight or flight is. You're stressed. You don't feel safe. So your body is taken over to do what its survival meant to do. But the soul is it's disconnected, because it's in 50 gajillion, whatever other realities the soul is playing in. So in this one, when you have, like, when we had the scan done, I'm like, oh, that makes sense. If you're in theta, then of course your body is in fight or flight, because it actually doesn't feel safe, because it feels like the controller that's supposed to be running the show of the body is not in it. So now the body's going to take over and survive, in a sense. So
that makes sense.
Yeah. And it was just like such a, like, it's like, it's stuff I know, but, you know, it's like another awareness of it. It's like, oh, whoa, that's wild. Mm-hmm. That makes perfect sense, because that we are again, we're tapping out into these other realities because they feel safer for whatever reason. We're not liking what's going on in this one. So we're going to disassociate and fly around in these ones. But now the body has to, the body's still trying to survive. And so this is where I go back to like the near-death experience too. Like I believe that when this body is incapable, like whatever's happened to it, whether it's disease, whether it was in an accident, whether it was like whatever it was, like the physical body is starting to fail, the soul can choose whether or not that existence is going to carry out or not. And I feel I know this pretty truthfully just by seeing the souls we've seen that are deciding whether or not they're going to play out this reality, or are they going to like tap into like another one? And that's honestly what I feel like happens is like,
me too.
I don't feel like we just fly up to heaven. Like that's not what I see when I like, I see different things for everybody because everybody's their own creator. So they're essentially creating what they go to next. That's the wild part. And I think a lot of it is like, we just now exactly what you experienced today, that you like decided to die in that life to now bring that part of your consciousness, soul, spirit, light, whatever we want to call it. To me, it's all the same thing. That energy that's been dancing in that physical body. You're like, all right, I'm going to bring it up into this reality because this is a higher vibration. So now I'm going to pull it into this one and carry this life existence out. Yeah. It's
fucking weird. It is weird, and I 1000% agree with you. I feel like heaven is literally just like
state of mind.
Yeah, and it's like, so I feel like we just keep being recycled, but I also feel like we can choose to go to these higher dimensions where it does feel like heaven compared to what we live in, right? Like, it does feel like, oh, look at the tree's dancing and I'm dancing too. Like it's because it's all about your energy.
Yeah.
And that's why today it was like I know these things, right?
Right.
That's why today when I'm seeing my other lives playing out that where I look the same and then ones I don't look the same, I'm like, oh, interesting. And I'm observing it, but I'm having my higher self, which is just a higher dimensional frequency of me, come in and hold my part. I'm like, huh. But like, here I am just observing, you know, like
an eye open
fucking Popeye over here. And I'm like, wow, I really do exist on all of these places.
Yep.
And so don't many of these people. And then I'm like, and then I saw Nico. There's more I was missing, but it doesn't matter. But they were all there and they're like, yeah. And I'm this person over here in this reality. I'm like, oh, that's cool. Like, what's up? And it's like, and that's why in this one, I do that, did this to you because in this one, I'm this. And I'm like, oh, it was like, I was being shown off.
Yeah.
Like every all dimensional aspect of me.
In a sense, all of your roles and like the different. Yeah. I know. I get it.
And like,
wild.
It's just, it's wild. And it's like,
it is.
When we die, I do believe we choose when we die. I do.
I do too.
And I totally agree with you that we disassociate because that's when I told you like I was the most disconnected from me and what emotionally was going on with me when I disconnected and I was in fight or flight at work my whole life until I was like shown this vision of if you keep going this way, you're going to die. Like you're going to be in that bed.
Like that body is not going to withstand. Yeah.
Sustain.
Exactly.
And so I was like, oh, okay. And it was like a warning sign. And I feel like we all get these warning signs, whether it be in our dreams or our waking states. And we can either take that warning sign, that intuitive hit, that our higher consciousness coming in, sharing that message with us, and either bring empowerment into it and be like, okay, I'm not going to have that reality. Or we're like, oh, fuck, that's going to be my reality. And then we stay in that reality, you know?
Right. We give our power away to it. To the fear of it. And then ironically, we create it.
Yeah. And I feel like when you say light quotient, I love it because that's what it was doing. Because it was all these different colors of light. And as we learned from that beautiful practitioner, color travels and heals faster than sound does, right? Like it brings your vibration up more. So when I'm seeing them in these, and I heard all these wind chimes too, when you're seeing them in these colored bubbles, it was bringing the energy of that color to their consciousness, that, or their fight or flight body, whatever their avatar in that life. And so, like, since I was doing shifting on me, it was vibrating out to them to also, like, hey, you have an option here. You have a potential that can be higher, more loving for yourself, exactly, if you want to join the party, right? Like, exactly. It's like, because I didn't see the raft. We learned that in shamanic, right? Like, where you steal parts and you release parts, that whole thing, however that works. Well, that's different conversation.
We've evolved from how we were taught. We'll
yeah.
But yeah.
So when they're on the raft in a big bubble, I'm like, oh, that's cool. And I see the raft float up and fly. And I'm like, okay, just let it go where it needs to go. Because people have the choice when they feel that shift of energy from whatever I did with me, myself.
Yep.
They can choose, I'm going to pull that bubble in and I'm going to join her on that reality, even though they probably won't be aware. Or they're like, nah, I'll stay here. Right? Like, but it was like, I sent them that light quotient, like you're saying. I was like, mm-hmm. So I sent them like, hey, I'm going up. If you want to join the team, we're going, mm-hmm. right? Mm-hmm. Or you're going to die, in a sense, like, or just keep repeating the same shit.
Right. And on the flip side of that, I also believe that people that we perceive to be asleep in this life have more light quotient in other lives where we perhaps don't.
Yes, correct. Yes. And I think that's also why they're in different... They play different roles in our lives. Like, and your husband was the cop in that other life, right? In the corner.
Yep.
And in this life is your husband, right? Yeah. In another life, he could be like your teacher. You could be his.
Correct.
But it's that's why it's like our tribe. It's like our soul family. But yep. It's also, I just think, fragments of our consciousness too.
Yes. Me too. Other versions. Yeah, I know. It gets fucking weird. Yeah. I'm like, wait, am I everybody in my reality?
Yeah, but... I think if we have that perspective, then we can have more empathy for everybody.
Correct.
Right.
Correct.
And for ourselves.
It really takes that whole, we are one, to that. It's like, oh my God, is everybody in my reality just a fragment of me?
Mm-hmm. And that, oh, that's also why I was shown that being eating my heart, and I had so much anger because it was telling me, like, because I wasn't sure if I was feeling my anger, like in my physical human vessel as now, or I was feeling that energy's anger. Because when it was eating my heart, it was like it was trying to, like, it was really weird. It was twisted. It was like, it was trying to protect me from anyone taking me, but it was also like, I'm taking it all for myself. Like, I'm getting all the light. Like, it was just weird. And it was like, but they had anger. Like, they had this rage. And the solar plexus, anger, resentment, solar plexus. You know, he was eating my heart. But you know what I mean? But it was like, as you were saying that, it's like, oh, there's another level of anger and resentment within me I need to see to release, because I am also just an aspect of that energy.
That's eating your own heart.
Was in fear of eating my heart. Yeah. Right. And it was like eating my heart for power, because it was obviously in fear of something else that it needed my light or felt like it would help them. But it was just an aspect, you know, it's just like, fuck, woo.
Another. Yeah, I know. It's crazy because it's like, we are the light and the dark. We are the fear and the love. We are all of it. So it's like, yeah, that when you were talking about that, what I was hearing was like, what's eating at your heart? Like, what's eating away at your heart? Like, when you were talking, I'm like, that's what I kept hearing. It's like, what's eating away at your heart? Because it's also very metaphorical too. As we know, everything they show us is also metaphorical. The metaphysical is metaphorical, but it's also very real. Wild. But it was like, that's what I kept hearing, is like, what's eating away at your heart? What's eating away at your heart? Because that's a very specific thing to kind of see, right? And so what eats away at all of our hearts? Fear is what's eating at the love, right? And so it's, again, it's just, to me, it's another manifestation of fears that maybe we perceive to be outside of us, but they're always in us too. They're in us, they can't not be in us. If we're this multidimensional, then we're playing in all of these dimensions of fear and love.
Correct.
Which from the higher perspective, it's all just love. That's the other fucking wild part, is that it's love fragmented into a very dense. Yeah. It gets cuckoo.
And that's why I feel like on these lower dimensions, though, like our love frequency, like we're living in the lower chakras. Like I feel like the more we elevate, the more we become those torches of illumination, or we have a higher aspect of ourselves come down and be like, hey, little you, it's time to grow up. It's like, I don't feel like there's a huge energy, and I may be wrong, but a huge energy of love on the lower dimensions. I feel like it's very survival still. Like,
well, yeah, that's it's why the lowest vibration history books, of love. So it's fear. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. That's why I like the history books, like, you know, cavemen. It's like, it's happening now still too, right? Like, still there. But it doesn't mean that they don't have that love. It's just like they might communicate it differently, but it changes the frequency of love. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah.
Just wild.
It's just brought it down into a dense form of it. Yeah.
Yeah. And I feel like the new earth, all the higher dimensional earth, whatever. That's why I'm shown me going elevator through these places. Cause I'm like, oh, hey, me on that one. Hey, millions of me on that one. Hey.
Seriously.
So it's really about, just like I gathered my tribe today. We are the new earth, because it's about our perspective. It's about our frequency. It's about our heart. It's about our energy. And like, we're ready to like do it right, in the sense, like feel healthy, feel full, right? Like feel empowered and do our business, but like still help others and help self. And that's the new earth, is like everything's brighter. It's different, but it's not like you're just, people think you just like shot up and you're put into another. It's like, you're probably still going to wake up in the same bed.
Correct.
But it's like,
but you see things brighter. Differently. And like, yes. I know that just from my own evolution these last 4 years, the more I shift my perspective, like literally everything looks different, even though I know it hasn't actually changed. It's how I'm perceiving it. It's like, mm-hmm. And it's just the same. Like if you're in a bad mood one day, mm-hmm. right? Some days you get up, you're just in a bad mood. Everything you see is going to irritate the fuck out of you. Things that didn't even irritate you before are going to irritate you, because your lens that you're looking through is super small and you're just in a shitty mood. So everything, like it could be raining unicorns and pots of gold, and like you'd still be like, no. No, don't say it, right? Because like you're just in a bad mood. But then flip that the other way. When you wake, you're in like this great mood, like nothing could shake that, right? Like there's some days where like literally nothing in my external can pull me out of that. That's when I know like I got a lot of light quotient in my body today, because ain't nothing gonna like change my perspective of how I'm seeing the world today, right? But it's constant. It's a constant. I mean, it's constant. That's constantly shifting and changing as we go through our different layers of lower dimensional us's. So it's, but that is literally, to me, that's why I say like new earth is absolutely already in existence. It's a matter of how much of my light quotient can I keep anchoring into the body? Cause it's in and out, right? Like there's more, some light, some days I got a lot of light up in there. And then other days it's like, yep, nope, not today.
And there's many reasons for that, like many external factors, all that. But do you feel like when we just wake up in a bad mood and we have no reason to be, do you feel it's like us on these lower vibrations just kind of like jumping in, or even on a higher vibration, right? Because the higher vibration self is going into a lower density.
And trying, like, I'm just to checking it out to what it just jumped into. Like, what is this?
Because if you're going from lower to higher, it can be uncomfortable too, because you're like, too much love. People are afraid of really warm hugs, love, right?
Yeah.
If you're going from higher to lower, it's like, this is fuck. Everyone's annoying on this level, right?
There's a lot of fear going on down here. Yeah. Like, so what you can be.
So I feel like when we wake up like that, or like just randomly when I've had those Walmart things where I just leave, and I'm like, and people, I realized I was yelling at people. I was like, I didn't even know I was running on autopilot. I was running on that fight or flight. Correct. But because my consciousness left because it needed to go somewhere else to do something, to help whatever, whoever, and then came back in my body. It's like these drop-in moments, right?
Exactly.
I feel like when we wake up and we're in that bad mood, it's because we are coming from a different frequency into kind of, hey, this is stuff you still got to work on. All right, just letting you know, going to go work on it. And you're like, wow, I'm fucking miserable. I don't even know why. Do you know what I mean?
And then
it's like, I know in a couple of days, I'll probably be tired, even though today I'm super energized.
Right.
It's me, my physical vessel adjusting to the energies, the shifting.
The light and quotient in your body.
The light quotient. Yeah. And the more compassion we have for ourselves when that happens, rather than like, oh my God, what's wrong with me? I'm so tired. Like, I know me and you text each other. I'm like, wow, I'm really tired today. But I'm not like pissed that I'm tired. I'm just like, right. Wow, right. Fucking tired today. But I also know it's energy. So something's happening.
Right. You saw me today as I'm about to yawn. Like I got a second wind to do this. But yeah, I was like, dude, I ain't got no energy. And you're like ready to go. I'm like, and we are so yin yang. Like I'm ready to like climb in the bed over there right now.
I love it.
But again, it's all about having compassion for whatever state we're in, because that's what shifts us out of it. That's the wild part. Like we, you know, the second we start judging how we're feeling, what we're feeling, what we're doing, we're literally trapping ourselves in that energy. We're literally like we're making ourselves be stuck in it the second we start doing that. So it's like, all right, I'm tired today. Don't have to know why. Just going to listen to it and go with it. And then tomorrow, I'll probably run a marathon. You know, I'm probably not. But...
Probably not. No, you won't see me run a marathon.
I won't ever do that. But well, I'll never say never. Maybe in another dimension I'm doing that, but not in this one. No desire.
No desire. Not at all. Nope.
Same.
So yeah, so I just wanted to share my story with everybody. Thank you.
Love it. We had a great multidimensional chat for people to wrap their linear brains around.
Yeah, this is what happens when you start like quotienting up. I don't know what to call it. But I think it's really too, when you just surrender and you stop resisting and you allow yourself to fully heal. You're just like, all right, what do I need to learn to feel whole, like more whole, right? Like fill my cup.
Exactly. And it's even too like, it's almost, I mean, I feel like there's a phase we go through. I went through where like, I am trying to figure all this stuff out. Cause as the human, that's what we're trying to do, is figure out like all of this. Mm-hmm. But I feel like I've surrendered to that. Like, it's kind of just like, I don't know, like I understand this is a process. Like, today we have this conversation and it makes sense to me again, right? But like in another week from now, I may have a completely different perspective, a completely different like, oh, but it's because again, it's happening in steps. Like for me to have come to this sort of understanding realization, I had to go through other steps or phases of becoming more aware. So it's like a ladder, like, you know, but I do feel like the less we're trying to figure all this out, because it's energy. And like, that's the analytical part of our brain that wants to figure it out and make sense of everything. Energy is not here to make sense. It doesn't actually make sense till you can actually just become one with energy. Then it's like, oh, this makes sense because I get energy. But it's like, it doesn't actually make sense. Energy has no sensical, logical rules around it. But then from the left side of our brain, we're literally trying to figure it out. And I know for me, the more I just surrender to like, I don't have to figure it out anymore, because it's just organically coming to me now. Like it's, the process of it is just naturally and organically happening, the less I'm trying to figure it all out, if that makes sense.
1000%. I love when you use the word organically. It just feels like so pure.
It feels like organic. Like it's just like, yeah, like, and I feel like that's why you and I have these experiences, because we're actually not really trying to do that. But it's like our consciousness and conscious self is like ready for that next seed, that next like level of, I don't like to say level, but that next stage of awareness or whatever. So it's like, we're not actually trying to figure it out anymore, because that's exhausting. But now it's like, it's just unfolding naturally. Yeah.
And
that's evolution.
It is.
You can't control it.
Interesting. Nope. Not even if you try.
No.
And like, I had a client at 11 and I was like, oh, I slept 2 hours. I should probably reschedule. And then I was like, but I have all this energy. I was like, but I should cuddle myself. And I was like having this like war. And I was like, wait, I just got my power. I just got my power back. This was the main message. Like, what? Sam, don't retreat. Don't retreat. So like I got up and I texted you. I was like, because Kevin came home and I knew something happened. It was like opposite. Like, I was like, okay, I'm going to get out of this. Okay. I don't need to sleep anymore. I'm just going to go because this is definitely not going to support the process because me and him never do that. So this morning I was like, okay, I don't know who it is, but I'm getting the fuck out of here. And I went for a walk and I was like, da, da, da. I was like, okay, it definitely wasn't me. And I'm like, I can do this session. I still been going. And I'm like, wow, it's really about perspective. It's literally about like, we know this, right?
I know.
Which is another layer. It's yeah. Like
it's another awakening of a knowing that we have, but then it's like, whoa. But now I really know it. And then like next year we're gonna be like, yeah, but now I
No, next year we're gonna be moving shit around with our eyes.
Right. Telekinesis, working on.
So everybody, check out our Solar Plexus podcast, our other podcast episodes, where we dive in deep. In smaller times to help you have more awareness and understanding of your avatar, your vessel, your human experience. And thank you for listening if you still are. And we love you.
We love you. Keep being your badass multidimensional selves. We'll see you in all of the other realities.
On the other side.
On the other side.
Uh-huh.